guys, welcome back to the channel. We got another video here for you today. And recently I had a chance to go and mix some live sound again. You know, it's been a little while with all the crazy stuff going on in the world, but got a chance to get back out there and do it again. And really enjoyed it and had a lot of fun and made me think, hey, let's get back to some audio here in DaVinci Resolve. Because, you know, I love me some good audio, and you should too, because even if your video is great, if your audio stinks, nobody's going to want to watch your video. So what I thought we could do is just start with some basics of setting levels here on a clip. And then what I'd like to do is just go through all of the features of the effects here in DaVinci Resolve. There's all kinds of stuff you can do there. So I'm thinking maybe it'd take one or two a week or something like that. We kind of go through and just see what they do, how they work, and try them out on some clips. And maybe give you some ideas of how you might want to use them in the future. So we're going to be starting off using just a basic clip here that I filmed of myself outside. I used a shotgun mic on top of my camera. I know in some of the other audio videos I did, I actually used this microphone, and this thing sounds so good out of the box that it's hard to see, or actually hard to hear, a lot of those little differences that we make with the audio. So we're going to start with a clip from a shotgun mic mounted to the top of my camera that I'm filming with 5D Mark IV here, because that's going to need a little more work to sound better. So hopefully it'll be a little bit easier to see the changes that we make. So we're going to jump right into DaVinci Resolve, start working with this clip here. And the first thing we need to do is set our levels. We need to make sure we've got a decent level and decent volume coming out of our clip. Otherwise, anything else we do may not work out so good. So we're going to focus on setting levels today in this video. And if it's going to be helpful, you can go ahead and download this file so you can follow along or try working with it and see what you can come up with. So I'll leave a link in the description below. You can head on over to my Buy Me a Coffee page. File will be free. You can go over, download that if you're interested in having a file to play with. Let's jump over into Resolve and set some levels. All right, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve. I've got my clip up on the screen here. And one thing I did forget to mention, you probably want some good headphones or some good speakers as you're working with your audio, because that's going to help you hear the little nuances better overall. So if you don't have a good pair of headphones, I'll link to a set in the description below that I've had for, oh man, I don't know, 10, 15 years. They work great and a little pricey, but they don't break the bank. I think when I got them, they were around 80 bucks or something. But anyway, some good headphones are going to go a long way for you when you're working with audio, or some good speakers if you have good speakers. If you don't have either one of those, don't worry about it. You're still going to be able to tune up your audio, make it sound better, and hear the differences on your computer with whatever speakers you might have. So let's get right into setting the levels here. So we want to listen to our track, see how it sounds, and decide where we need to go from there. Now, you don't want to just listen to it, because your ears can be a little deceiving, and depending on what kind of speakers or headphones you're using, the volume of your clip is going to sound different. So we're going to want to rely a lot on the meters here in DaVinci Resolve to tell us where we are with our sound levels. So we can start to do this right here in the Edit tab if you'd like, or you can jump into the Fairlight tab. If you were going to do it in the Edit tab here, you want to make sure you come up here and you've got your mixer open, so that way you can see some levels and what's going on there. But since we're going to be talking a lot about Fairlight in this whole little series that I'm working on here, we're actually just going to jump right into the Fairlight tab and get going over there. So click on the little musical notes here, that'll bring you right over to the Fairlight tab. So here we are in the Fairlight tab. We've got the track of me talking, and I'm actually going to relabel this. I'll just call this vocal and rename the track. You can just double click in there. So let's get into setting these levels. And just real quick too, make sure your interface matches mine. If you want to just come up to Workspace here, come down to Reset UI Layout, then we should all be looking the same and you should be able to follow along pretty easily here. So let's play through the clip. I'm going to look at my meters at the top here, and I can also look at my meters over here and see how my levels are doing. So let's play through and see what we've got. What's happening, guys? Here is our sample audio clip we're going to be using as we work through the Fairlight tab here. We're going to be doing everything from setting our levels to adding in some effects and hopefully seeing what all the effects here do in the Fairlight tab. So this is the sample clip we're going to be starting with. I'm going to make this available to you guys to use so that you can follow along if you want to. So let's get into editing some audio. Okay, so there's our audio clip. And if you watch the meters there, you see it was mostly in that green area, right? It didn't get up much higher than that. So this is the way that I like to do it. Again, some people might have some different opinions on it, but what I like to do is get my vocal or talking tracks somewhere in that minus 10 to minus 15 range, which on the meter here is going to be in that yellow range. All right, so you might be thinking, all right, well, I've seen some other YouTube videos about audio, and some people say they want it, you should boost it up to the red, or, you know, get that audio as high as you can. And I know where they're coming from, and I understand that, because when you're uploading stuff to YouTube, you've got certain loudness levels that you can boost up your audio to. It's called LUFS. And I do have a video on that. I'll link to it up here if you are interested in checking out a video about loudness. But what I like to do is set all my levels to where they should be and then boost it at the end a little bit, because depending on the platform you're doing, whether you're doing YouTube, you can boost things up a little higher. If you're doing broadcast stuff, that level that you can have your loudness at is a little bit lower. So what I like to do is just set my mix and set my audio levels at the point that they should be, and then I can either boost it or lower it a little bit at the end. And if you've seen some of my other videos, you also know that there's plugins that can do all this stuff too. But you can do it manually and just use the tools that are right here in DaVinci Resolve. You don't have to use plugins and all that. It might take a little bit more work. Sometimes it doesn't take more work. But keep that in mind. I'm going to set my levels how I would for any project, and then I'm going to make adjustments to the overall loudness at the end. So if you've heard about that a little bit, and you know the loudness levels for YouTube or whatever, we'll get to that at the end later on in the series, but you can check out that loudness video that I linked to up there before if you're interested in that. All right, let's get back to it. Okay, so we've got a few different ways that we can start to set our levels here. So you notice I have a stereo track here, and you can make it a mono track. As a matter of fact, why don't we do that? We're gonna just come and right-click on our track, come down to change track type to and mono, because for what I'm doing here and for this speaking track, mono is gonna work just fine. So you've got a few different ways to set the levels on your track here. The quickest way you can get a good baseline level started here is to click on your track. You can right click and come up to normalize audio levels. Now, normalizing is a way of setting your levels for your clip based on different parameters. So for example, you've got sample peak program, you've got true peak, and these are the two that I generally use. The rest of these are set up for other things such as broadcast TV and other things that we're not going to get into right now. But I would recommend you use either True Peak or Sample Peak Program. The one that I typically use is True Peak. I'm going to click on that. And you see here it's set at -2. So that's going to bring us all the way up into the red there. And for me and what I typically like for my audio, that's too high. I don't want it to be that high because, like I said, I want my levels to be in that -10 to -15 range and peak somewhere maybe around -8, -9, somewhere around there. So I'm actually going to come in here, I'm going to double click this, and I'm going to select -8.0 and see where that gives us. And then I'm going to click normalize. So what that does is it takes the highest peak here, which would be say this. And if we watch our meters when we play through, it should set that level at -8 for the max peak value. So let's see how that works out, and let's watch our meters here as we play through.
What's happening, guys? Here.
So you can see right here, that red line, that's where we peaked at, which is -8, which is exactly what we just set in normalizing our audio. So what I want to do now is play through the rest of my clip, because look at the rest of our waveforms here. They're definitely lower than where this peak was. So it might be like a false level kind of our overall track. We might actually want to boost this up some more, but I want to watch the meters as I play through and see where everything falls now.
Here is our sample audio clip we're going to be using as we...
So as I'm talking now, you can see we're low. We're between the 15 and 20. So what I want to do is boost it up some more. And again, you've got a couple ways to do it. You can come right here and hover over this white line. You're going to get this little icon, and that allows you to raise the volume of it. So that's one way you can do it. You can come over here and open your inspector by clicking on this icon. And then you've got your volume right here. You can raise and lower. It does the same thing. Or you can come over here, and this is your fader level. So if you drag it down, drag it up, you can see my faders moving at the same time I'm moving this up and down. But what I'd like to do is actually set the volume of the clip before moving the fader at all. So I'm going to reset my fader by double-clicking on it. And let's say I want to boost this guy up a little bit more. And now I know this peak right here is going to be a little bit higher than I want it to be, but that's okay for now. We'll take care of that in a little bit. So now let's play through our clip and watch our meters over here.
What's happening, guys? Here is our sample audio clip we're going to be using as we work through the Fairlight tab here.
So I think it can come up even a little bit more. I'll boost it up a little bit more there. And let's play through and see how it's looking.
As we work through the Fairlight tab here, we're going to be doing everything from setting our levels to adding in some effects and hopefully seeing what all the effects here do in the Fairlight tab. So this is the sample clip we're going to be starting with.
So I think that looks pretty good. I'm going to leave that right there for now because we've got some decent levels started here. But now what about this peak here? How are we going to handle that? Well, let's play through the clip and just see what kind of level we got here on our meters.
What's happening, guys? Here is our...
So that's peaking up around, I don't know, what's that, -4 maybe? So a few ways we can handle this. If we want to lower just this little section here, we can use some keyframes to do that if we'd want. So I can come here. I'm going to click a keyframe. I'm going to move over couple frames, and then I'm going to hit the keyframe again, and now I can just grab this and lower it down so it's a little more in line with the rest of the waveforms here, and that should work out pretty good. So let's see where that falls.
What's happening, guys? Here is our sample audio clip we're going to be using as we work through the Fairlight tab here. We're going to be doing everything from setting our levels to adding in some effects and hopefully seeing what all the effects here do in the Fairlight tab. So this is the sample clip we're going to be starting with. I'm going to make this available to you guys to use so that you can follow along if you want to. So let's get into editing some audio.
So I think that's pretty good. We can even come over here and maybe boost this just a little bit more, get a little bit more out of it. We noticed in the beginning here, it was a little bit lower as far as the levels were concerned, but that's all right. You know, we're going to continue to work with this clip. And when we get to the dynamics panel and go over that, I'm going to show you how to boost the makeup of the clip a little bit here, as well as add some compression, which is going to help with everything and help it all sound better. All right, guys, so there we go. That is pretty good, I think, for our levels here. Again, if you want to do it the quickest way, you can run that normalization one and do one of those first two options, and it's going to give you a good baseline. It's going to set your peak level and adjust everything else accordingly. So it's a good way to just kind of get started and jump start it. A lot of times for me, I'll just use the normalization. I don't really go through and, you know, use keyframes and adjust different parts of my audio clip. Again, if you're doing some, like, you know, professional work for TV or whatever, you're probably going to do that. But if you're just doing YouTube stuff, for me, it's not worth that effort. And I think the results from normalizing and making a few minor adjustments are good enough, as well as using other tools and effects that we're going to get to as we move on in this series. So if you have any questions about setting the levels of your dialogue tracks, definitely leave a comment down below. I'll help you out the best that I can. And maybe later on, we'll get to what do you do with music and background music? How do you set the levels for that? Where should they fall in relationship to your, you know, dialogue tracks? So we'll get into that later on in another video. But for now, we got our levels set. And next, we're going to be moving into some EQ. And then we'll follow that up with some dynamics in the dynamics panel. And then we'll move into all the effects. And maybe we'll cover, you know, like I said, 1 to 2 effects a video, or just depends on how involved the effect is. Go through it and see what they all do and give you guys an idea of how maybe it could work for your videos. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope it was helpful. I hope that this is going to be a series that helps you get better audio out of your videos, because it's hard to watch a video with audio that stinks, right? So hopefully this series will help you out, get you some good audio. So thank you guys for watching. Thumbs up if you liked it and learned a little something. Subscribe to the channel if you want some more videos like Quick Tip Tuesday. Great series. Love that. If you want to know more about audio and video in DaVinci Resolve, as well as how to grow your YouTube channel, because I know a lot of you guys are trying to grow just like I'm trying to grow. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.
Luke, I am your father.
Actually, my favorite one is in Spaceballs when he's drinking the coffee, right? Rick Moranis, no?
Too hot, too hot.
Anyway, great movie, great movie.